Okay guys, welcome back to my channel Rezan Dekanugro. Right now I'm gonna do reaction for and from you guys suggestion recommendation in column comment section, and this time is from Karasu. Karasu commented on my video reacting the engrave song called Pinuska. Karasu said, "Thanks for reacting to Dear and Grey. For your information, this song is not from the same show as the last one you heard." What the last song I heard before Pinuska? I forgot. This one was on Androgynous live in Yokohama Arena, and the other one was in Modo of Ouroboros 2016-2017 live, which is from the 2008 album. Wow, old song. I leave it recommended for you here. Macabre Live Tabula Rasa 2013 is a 6-minute masterpiece with subtitles, and in this one you will able to see more than the member are capable of. And except that, you guys pointing me out about like I recognizing the guitarist using ESP Viper in baritone in purple color, and yeah bro, that's really cool act, you know, to have baritone 24 fret. Wow, just cool equipment bro. So yeah, I think because this is a long video, 6 minutes, so this is the deal. I gonna give you note before I'm jumping to the song. If I have some opinion, if I have some commentary, analysis, anything that comes out from my mouth, I'm not gonna pausing the video. I'm just gonna straight while the song is playing. So I have been warning you, I have been saying to you. So yeah, let's get jumping to it. Dear in Gary Gray Macabre Live. Let's go. Oh, this long video. 2013. Wow. Okay. This is some kind of build up for intro. Yeah, that ESP baritone. This is clearly not the same show, right, as the last video that I checked. This feel different. Oh, there's a lot of guitar there. Oh, 6 rings? Hold on. Is it 6 rings? Six rings. Hold on, I'm gonna back up a little bit. This touch not 6 string, that's 7 string. Yeah, that's 7 string. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yeah, 7 string. 7 string full fret. That's cool. Wow. I bet that acoustic. Okay. That doesn't feel right. Hold on, is that ESP Viper have piezo on it? Because if electric guitars sounded like acoustic, there must be piezo, you know, some kind of piece of hardware that make your guitar electric turning to acoustic, you know. Okay, strat. Wow, a lot of guitar for one song. Yeah. Wow. Somehow this kind of this song is different from any Green Grey song so far, you know. This is really different, you know, from any other Green Grey song I've listened so far. It's like emo, but in the Green Grey way. I love, you know, they have different work, you know, like the right guitarist doing some clean, like picking like that, and the other one, GSP guy, kinda soloing, and the bass just riffing, you know. Like that, I love that. Wow, this is like psychedelic plus emo plus goth. Yeah, yeah, psychedelic for sure. Wow. Is it for? This is from 2013 and it's still cool in 2022. Wow. It proved that the Green Grey music is relatable all the time. I love this kind of psychedelic rock, maybe. I'm gonna say that. Like demon, you know. Wow. I know why. This is masterpiece song. I know why now. This is clearly psychedelic rock at this song. Oh man, I rather listening this than Tame Impala if I want to hear some psychedelic. If Bach live in this era, it will be Wow, that guy sound like Megadeth guitarist. I forgot what the name. God to psychedelic rock. This is the full run and experience from any other NGA song that I ever watch, you know. I'm gonna give it 10, of course, because how different is this from the rest of the NGA song that I heard, you know. Man, what experience is this? I'm gonna give it 10 out of 10 because this is just different. This is just unique on its own, you know. It feels like they are owning some genres, you know. Great. Thank you, said it. If you like it, give a like, share, comment, and see you on the next video. Bye bye.